we're going to put some Daihatsu back in the Daihatsu. Well, here we are again. Going to finish off this C4. As you can see, I haven't touched any of it. Been too busy. That's all right. Chassis repairs are done in the Fairlane. It's good. While I had the motor out, I went to put a rear main seal in it and found out that the bearings were worn out. So. So I threw bearings through the whole motor. Didn't film any of that. I just got it done. So motor's sitting there ready to go. So the last piece of the puzzle now is that big bench pile of parts that I've put back in there somehow, all in there. So we'll get into it, I suppose. It's gotta happen sometime.
All right, first thing to do. Case is stripped. I gotta replace this bush in the tail right there. Probably don't have to, there's nothing really wrong with this one, but I'll do it anyway. I'm not really going by the book. The book wants you to assemble all the sub assemblies, so the pump, valve body, the clutch packs and all that first. I want to get the bush and the sprag done in the case first and then focus on all of that. So I'll knock that out, push this one in as gently as I possibly can, and we'll go from there. That's that one out. Yeah, there's all the little ports on the side there. I'm going to roughly line one up to the oil return port in the back here. Don't really need to, there's a big relief cut on the inside of the case, but that's the way the original one was, so that's the way I'm going to do it. Probably should just take this to the workshop and push them all in with the press, but I'm stubborn. Flush, flush. Just below flush, so it's flush on the inside. Okay. Now time for the sprag. Which goes all the way down in there. I don't know if you remember from the last video. Consists of that, which is on the main drive on the back of the clutch bells. These are your wave springs. And then you've got a series of dowel pins that go around the edge like that, so that when you clunk it into reverse, it locks up and then spins the main shaft backwards. So the idea of those wave spins is there's little ramps in this housing down here. As you put it in reverse, it tries to spin that backwards, which then pushes the pins higher up on the ramps in there, which then locks the main shaft and then drives it in reverse, or locks the first reverse, the back of the first reverse drum, which then in turn drives the entire gear set backwards, then driving the main shaft backwards. That's probably a better explanation. These wave springs are quite prone to breaking, especially in older C4s and power glides. I thought there was a busted one in this one, but it's all right. But the kit, the master kit I bought, has got new springs, new dowels, so I'll just change everything. There's also a thrust washer all the way down the bottom there. This one is blued, so it's damaged as well. I don't know if you can really see that. Probably not. So, put a new thrusty in there. We'll throw the sprag together, and then we'll start on the pump and clutch packs. Alright, minor change of plans. I got that tail bearing in, went to go over to my rebuild kit, my Stage 2 Master rebuild kit, and grabbed the thrust washer out that I need. That one. Went all the way over here, busted it open, and there's no thrust washers in it. It's got everything else. Seals, carbon seals for the pump, every gasket, sprag, spring setups there. That's the valve, don't worry about that. That's my shift kit. Full clutch pack there, fans. And no thrust washers. So there goes putting the C4 back together. I can build some of the components, like I can assemble the tail house and put the new tail bush in that because it's a bit damaged and rear seal. I can build the pump and the valve body, and I think I can build the 3-4 clutch pack because it doesn't have a thrust washer internally. It's external, so I can put the thrust washer on it later. But the first and the reverse clutch pack has a thrust washer underneath the clutch plates, so that ain't happening. So I guess I'll build some of it, and I don't know whether I'll bother filming putting it back together or what. I just bought the thrust bearing kit for it, another $70. I thought that master rebuild kit over there was going to have a minute. I'm guessing they don't. So, yeah, that's all right. I'll leave that for now. I can't put sprag or anything in it because that goes underneath the reverse sprag. So that's literally a bare case now. So I'll move some of this shit off the bench. Might throw the pump up. And I'll jam the new pump gears and seal kit in that. Yeah, we'll see. All right. I've got the front seal and the bearing pushed in. So I've got the old pump there. Nothing really wrong with this, a little warm. But the kit comes with a replacement, so we'll throw the new one in. I've packed a bit of ATF assembly lube in there, just to help it on startup, just the same as like building an engine or anything like that. Squeeze that down in there. I'll pack more into the teeth. Don't want to kill the pump straight away. This one does not ride on the thrust bearing, it floats in oil, so you can just drop this straight in. Try and thumb a bit into the back here. And this ATF or auto trans assembly grease is ATF based, so it dissolves in trans fluid. So you can't just use standard engine assembly lube because it won't dissolve. You could if you're in a pinch, I suppose, but you just have to change the filter and oil after you run it. And I'll drop this in. Okay, so those two flats inside there, that's what your torque converter drive. Well, that's how your torque converter drives the pump. There. So, put the ramps forward, so it's easy to line the torque converter up. You can put that in backwards. It doesn't hurt anything. It just makes it harder to put the torque converter in because you've got a blunt start. So just jam a bit more in there, just in the top. Probably going overboard, but hey, I bought the whole tub. I'll use the whole tub. Okay. Now, there. Alright, that's that part of the case seal pump done. Get that off, put that over there. There's your input seal there. Obviously your torque converter shaft goes through there, so you've got to be gentle pushing that in that you don't damage it. That's why a press would be handy, but oh, I'm a backyard mechanic. Now, one issue I have, well, it's not really an issue, when the torque converter failed, the rotor, yeah, because the stator's on the outside, I'm talking about rotor, rode forward and it actually burred and damaged the end of that. So I'm going to put another chamfer on the end of that on both sides. I've got a countersink here. That's the back side of the pump body. It does not seal with the gasket. It's face-to-face. It's supposedly precisionally machined. The way the rest of this gearbox is going, it probably ain't. But that's okay. As long as it pumps oil, I don't care. So I'll clean that up. It's only cast iron, it shouldn't take much. Slam that in there. And then I've got to change all these little carbon seals on the back here. They're just like piston rings. They insert into one of the clutch bells. So you can see they sort of squeeze in there. So, and because they're carbon or graphite, they're very delicate and you can break them very, very easily. So that's fun. I'll knock a chamfer onto this and I'll start doing that. All right, we're changing out the carbon seals. I've got the bottom ones on, I got a bit carried away. So I've got the last two to go, and you just got to match up which ones are which. So it's going to be these two here. They're the thickest of the bunch. I don't know if you can see that they've got little teeth that interlock. So they go in the groove and then click. They're like a total seal piston ring. So you just walk them down. And just like a piston ring, you want to offset all your joints, but I won't be doing that until I'm putting this together. So for now, I'll just box it up. And then that will be the pump done. So just push it over, gently latch that over there. And then once it goes into the housing, it'll compress up. Perfect. Same as the bottom ones. Good. Right, that's the pump done. Now, there's supposed to be a thrust washer that goes on the top of that to build it. There's also one that goes on the base. Also, I don't have any of them, so we'll leave that there. These two other carbon seals that come in the packet are for further internal. So we'll sort that out later. Okay, now on to building the forward clutch assembly. So this is third and fourth gear clutch pack. There's a bearing in there. And then on the back side here, that's where two of those carbon seals on the pump grip. You can sort of see the shiny bits. I don't know if it's coming up. So I've got to do the bearing. We'll pop this clutch pack out. So just this one circle. There we go. You can also see how easily I can push those clutches down. They're pretty badly worn. It should be a wee bit tighter underneath that circlip. So right. There you go. There's your steels and your fibers. Big block goes down the bottom. We'll put that back in there. Probably leave it out later. Fiber steel, just like a motorbike clutch. These ones aren't too bad. I wonder why it didn't have that much spring on it. I might add another steel under it to give it a bit more clamp force there. That used to be an old trick back in the day. You can see all the metal still in it. That'd explain why the gearbox never slipped. Because the clutch packs are all good. There's a bit of scoring on the plates there, but the kit comes with new plates, so that's all right. Sit that there. Now I've got to punch that bearing out. Jam another one into it, and we'll go from there. And bearing's a bit cooked. All right, once you get your clutch packs out, this piston sits at the bottom. That's what ramps up and gives you your clamp pressure on your clutch packs. So there's a seal on the piston, and there's a seal all the way down in the bottom there, or supposed to be. This one is missing, so that doesn't help. The seal that's on the piston is also worn and flat to the housing, so I'll replace that. I'll be careful when you're compressing this spring, because it's got a dick load of spring pressure, like ridiculous. Auto transmission shops have actually got a tool where it comes, it's foot operated, a rod comes up through the middle of this whole bell, and then it's got like a big cup that'll sit on that, and then you can push it down with your foot, compress that, pop this snap ring off. I had to make do with a Daihatsu selector and a bit of rod like that in my vise. and compressed it that way, and then just picked the circlip out afterwards. So it's going to make it a bit fiddly to put it back together, but what do you do? Not much you can do about it. I'll get this seal changed out, get a seal in here, clean it out with some brake clean. I've got the new shims soaking in oil. Same with motorbikes, you should always soak them with oil in oil before you put them back in, or put them in general. So get those seals changed, pop that back in, get that spring compressed back in, and then I'll throw a clutch pack on that, and that's that drum done. I marred the top face of that bearing a little bit, knocking it in, but it should be okay. So this rear piston, the other thing I noticed when pulling it out, I don't know if you can see it on camera, there's a little check ball there. That had actually come out. So I've put that back in and peened it. The other thing of note with these is they don't use a standard round O-ring. They use a rectangle or square section O-ring. So it's, yeah, flat. So when you're putting the new one in, you want to make sure you don't have any twists in it. Also, you've got to make sure you get the right one for the groove. Yes. So, a little bit fiddly putting it in, but it'll go in eventually. Okay. O-ring's nice and proud of the housing. It's good. The old one wasn't. Throw that one in the back of that, and I can compress it back together. Build that clutch pack, and then that's the forward clutch pack done. Right, there's the drum, ready to assemble it. I've got me plates. I've already put one clutch pack and plate in. Didn't film it. I've got me bucket of clutches sitting in oil. Just good practice. You don't want to put them in dry. And I'm just going to roughly line up those teeth. Another plate. Another friction. Now what I will do to line the teeth up all the way before I put the snap ring on is I'll drop the other side of the bell on. Actually, the other thing is there's different thickness plates. I don't know if you can see that. This is a thicker one. The thicker one they put in to adjust a bit more clamping pressure on it. The kit comes with a replacement thick one, so I've just put the thick one in it because that's what it had currently. You want to put it in the middle of your clutch pack, roughly in the middle. And again, and my top steel. All right, now we've got the basket. That should be that one. Should be that one? Yeah, so. I'm just gonna sort of chip it in together. There we go. So now that's all the clutch plates lined up. Come on now, baby. There is enough play, you can do it after, it's just easier to line them up roughly now. Drop our snap ring in. There we go, into the groove, that's good. Now I'll put me center back in. If I can. There we go. Yeah. All spins freely. Just pushing down on the head of that. Cool. Now if I wanted to, I could probably replace one of those other steels with another thick one to give me a bit more clamp force. That does seem a little loose. I'll consult the manual here. If I don't have to, I won't. If I do, I will.
We'll see. But that's it. Assembled. You can hear that. It had that in it previously, but the clutch pack was warm, so I'm going to have to put a thick steel in it. All right, next drum up. Similar thing. Gonna get this snap ring out first. There's a lot of metal underneath this snap ring. Now there is a wave spring, they call it, on the bottom here. And didn't give me an issue. Sometimes they can pop up pretty aggressively, apparently. Got a nice thick plate on the top here. That sort of doesn't want to come out because it's cemented in with dead gearbox material. But she'll come. Come here. Come on now. Alright. Yeah. There we go. Look at all that metal in there. Put that down. Alright, here's all our frictions. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. So, V8s and V6s had different amount of frictions in this basket. 6s had 4, V8s had a variety depending on year model, but most of them are 5 friction plates, which is what this has. Which is good. Still doesn't explain why it exploded, but that's fine. And then it is just full of metal. So I'll have to get these into a bit of Chemtool supply brake plane. The 5 friction discs. Pull the last plate out and get the wave spring out. There's a seal in the back there I've got to change and all that fun stuff. So these steels are all the same thickness too, which is cool. That. And you can see they're sort of convex for that back plate that pushes on that wave spring. Another snap ring to get that out. Okay. Gonna have to two-hand it. Come on now. Nah, of course you dropped into the other groove. Come on now. There we go. Well, snap ring, wave spring. There we go. See? It's also full of metal, so that's good. And down in the bottom there, there's an O-ring. This one's split. It's not supposed to be. Also hard, which is bad. So, and a check ball valve. That's still in good nick. I have to give this all a hose out because it's just full of material. Interesting. Good thing I've got a 20 litre drum of brake clean because I'll be using her a bit, I think. Alright, friction plate time. And how many do they give me? 5, good. Alright, one of them. One of these. One of them. One of these. Seems like a bit of a waste of ATF to just sort of have them have a bucket of it just open to air floating around, but I've got like 12 litres of it there, so I went a wee bit overboard buying fluid. It uses old school Type F, not just Dextran 3. Type F tends to be a bit thicker, I hear, which is why a lot of the old boxes go for it. And if you've got one that's a bit slippy, if you can flush it all the way out, because Type F and Dextran 3 don't mix, if you can flush it out and fill it with Type F, apparently it can help prolong the gearbox failing. I just fucked that up. I've got to put a snap ring on top of the wave spring.
I'm an idiot. Well, this comes back out. I'll delicately sit that over here. Let's put a snap ring in. Well, they say, if you're not laughing, you're learning. Which is a good thing too, I suppose. So. Let's put all these back in. It's always a way, going too quick or think everything's going good. The next minute, they'll be pulling it apart again. I think that was the last one too, so onto the top friction plate. Okay. This one's going to be a bit harder to line up. Goes inside this bell over here. Oh, come here. Yep. Ah, it won't be that hard to line up because it comes apart. There we go. Now on the inside of that there's supposed to be a thrust washer, much the same as this one that's here. But there ain't, so the rest of the assembly, I still got a little bit of stuff to build, and then this just gets put on the back burner until my thrust washer kit turns up. Now that the part of the internals are done, it's time to fit the reverse and first or low servo. So verify that it fits. I'm gonna give her a lube up. Put it on the edge of the seal too, just to help. So it's got a return spring and the pressure hits this side of it. That's why the seal there, the high side of the seal is on this side because that's the oil side. Not to say the other side doesn't have oil on it, but it's not under pressure. It's just open to the cavity back into the gearbox pan. Put our spring in, our piston on. See, the spring wants to push it back out. Push makes sure it wants to go in, which it does. Alright, time for the cap. This, of course, has a seal on it as well. Another square section seal for some reason. I'm not sure why they bothered with this. I think the upgraded caps you can get just have an O-ring in them, because square section seals are annoying. And I'll throw a bit of grease on there too, just in case. That was probably a bit too much grease. Whatever. Cool. This one doesn't have an orientation, it just sits on there. pull this in square. You don't want to pinch that piston in there. So I probably should get a socket that fits this. Maybe it's already on again. Huzzah, it is. Sweet.
Alright, time to replace the next servo. So it's got another set of square section O-rings, the cover's got a gasket, and it's also got another square section O-ring. This one takes a lot of pressure, it's your intermediate band. So that's the one you're going to be operating on most of the time when you're driving. So they want to make damn well sure it don't leak, because it's getting all of the pressure. I've seen some C4 race cases where this housing's beefed up and it's actually got an O-ring inlet into it. Because once you start getting super big line pressures using line locks and stuff like that, it'll probably push a gasket out. But the old Fairlane Shannon drag car, despite the fact that I've used it as one for a little while. Gasket on, servo's pushed into the housing, lots of ATF grease behind there, spring on. And then we just slide it together to sort of support the spring a little bit. It's got little teeth that it's got to sort of line up on. I'm going to rotate it as I push it in. Now there's a fair bit of spring pressure on this, so I'm going to have to I'm going to have to put the gasket on the housing first. Let's try to roll. Righto. Fuck you. Workshop manual. Doing it the way you told me to, and it doesn't work. Right, let's try this again. Come on now, don't get fiddly. Jeez Louise, that's tight. Doing its thing, yeah. I just didn't want to pinch that seal. But looks like I got her. There we go. I don't know if you remember about the last time I was having a yarn about these caps with the letters on them. So A is supposed to be the biggest one, biggest piston, heaps of line pressure. I had a look, this is an R. R's, and I think it was a T, they're used in like heavy vehicles. So it's basically the equivalent of the A drag race one. They put them in like F250s and up, big heavy cars, and it was going to be pulling a pretty big load. So that's why I didn't bother putting a one of the billet race caps on it, because this is pretty much as big as it goes anyway. There's other ones where like the piston actually, instead of sitting in the cap here, it sits in the housing, and then that cap's basically just a flat cap, and that gives you all of the clamp pressure, but I ain't gonna need that. So we just run with this one. I mean, if the Fairlane ends up being a drag race machine, it's going to need a shitload more work than a built C4. So. Okay, change the seals on the band adjusters and the cooler line feeds. So now I'm going to put this governor housing on. It also covers the park gear. Actually, I can't, because it's got a thrust washer in it. Let's have a look at it. If it's good, we'll run it. It's only one thrust washer out of all of them. Oh, it's fine. Cool. Give that a rinse off in me bucket of parts washer. Let's see. Some shiny marks where it's been rubbing, but that's fine. I want to do something. I'm going to give this a rinse too. Okay. Now you've got to line these two little pipes up with a couple of holes in the casing there. It's a wee bit delicate. You sort of got to jiggle it. I've seen videos of like people driving them on with a hammer and then complaining that they've bent the pipework, so it slipped off, so it should slide back on. There's no gasket under it, it just gets bolted straight on. So that's that. And I'll bolt that down. Inside of this housing here, I don't know if you can see from all the way over there, there's some shiny marks. Those shiny marks are from another set of carbon seals on the apple shaft. Just there. So that goes into there, like so. And then all those little seals grip on there. Then this governor goes on the back. It's got a couple of ball bearings and some pistons in there. Be able to box up some. Bolt that down, change those seals out, knock that in. There's a circlip that holds it on the other side, which I won't be able to put on yet because it goes in front of the main sprag. So I'll put that on though, do the bearing and the tail housing, and then box the arse end of this gearbox up. And then again, I'll be waiting for thrust washers. Now just delicately slide these over here without breaking them, because just like piston rings, they're very fragile. And I'll just sort of walk them over. One to go. This will be the one that I break, no doubt. Oh, or not. Perfect. That's fine. Now come here. And let's load the shit out of that with ATF grease. Seeing as it's basically metal on metal. And I'll also do where that bearing goes. Delicately slide this in without breaking any of those. What am I missing? What am I missing? Or is it just tight on that new bearing I put in the back? In the back of the housing. Could be. I don't think it is that. No, it is. There we go. Okay. Right. That's that. So it is tight in the bearing there, but it's going to be. It's all brand new, so that's that. I should be able to put this rear housing on, rinse. Supposed to be a little filter in here, and the kit didn't come with a replacement, and it's not in here currently, so bug it. And again, no gasket on this face, it's just precision machined. It's actually snow ground by the looks of that. That fucking seal or something silly on it, doesn't it? Definitely doesn't. All of those move freely. In there with me modification. So there's two plungers in this thing, and only one of them's got a return spring on it. So this long side here, I'll spin it around, that long side, it relies on gravity. And if you start getting issues with shitty oil or material going through it, that'll stick and it won't shift correctly, much like how my Fairlane was. So the fix, or one of the things that I learnt off of YouTube, is you put a little ball bearing in there. And then as it's winging around, if it does get stuck, the weight of the ball bearing smacks it back into position and smacks it loose. So I've done that. Alright, tail housing assembled, bearing, seal in. Gaskets tacked onto the back with a bit of ATF grease. Go and slide this in nice and gentle like, and box it up. Now this bolt I won't be able to put in because there's a little bracket that holds the vacuum modulator on, and I can't put that in without the valve body being in. So I'll put all bar that one in and leave it at that for now. I think that'll be everything I can do on the case. I think that's probably going to be everything I can do, period, until these thrust washers turn up. Yeah, that's right. We'll get this bolted down and there we go. Now I've done as much as I can to the casing of the auto, time to move on to other stuff. So, this is the valve body. As you can see, it's still got shit coming out of it. I'm going to put a shift kit in. The kit I'm going to use is actually a full manual kit, because that seems like a great idea for a daily driver. But it can be returned to automatic at any time. It's like you've got to put, you can do it in the car. You've got to put two more check balls that you remove to full manualize it back in and change the spring. So if I don't like it, I'll just change it. So it's a Transgo shift kit. It seems to be the go-to everyone uses in a C4. I got it from Wholesale Automatics in Victoria. So just reading through the instructions, because it covers all C4 year models and C10. So in America, they call what I have here a case fill C4, or pan fill C4, sorry, because the dipstick tube goes into the pan. The early models were a case fill, obviously dipstick tubes in the case. In Australia, we call dipstick tube in the case a C4 and dipstick tube in the pan a C10. So I just rang them and said, what do I need? It's this year model, this is what it is, and then they sent me the one I needed up, so that's good. The C6 uses a completely different setup, so you've got to get a C6 shift kit if you got a F truck and you want to, I don't know, make it shift like shit. So bust this apart and start working out where I've got to drill holes, which balls I've got to take out, all of that fun stuff. That fucking stinks too.
Alright, popped her apart, give her a wash. I just marked these two holes have got to be enlarged to, what are they, 0.110 of an inch, the drill supplied, so I'll drill them out. And this is why they send gaskets with the kit, because it just fell apart. Plus you need like the full manual gasket, it's got different passages and shit in it to get it to do the job. So now I've got to try and clean that up, which is great. Now we're all cleaned up, we can start putting it back together. I've got my separator plate drilled out. There and there, just deburred them with a razor blade so they're flat. Okay, start from position one, orifice control plug install with assembly lube, which I have on it, and it's gonna go right there. Cool. Alright, so now here, no check ball there, and there, no check ball there. And over here, reinstall plastic check ball. So I grabbed one of the replacements and put that in there. The one that came out of there was actually undersized. It has to be 5mm. The one that came out of it was 2mm. All right, now we have the spring assembly, spring and check ball assembly. This is gonna go, where are we gonna go? Right there. Come on now, yeah. Okay, spring and check ball, so that goes there. Perfect. So that. Okay, now I can put my separator plate on, but I need a gasket. So I'll go get a gasket.
All right, got the right gasket in. They send you with like four different gaskets. Two of them are to return it back to automatic, and the other two are to suit the different year model autos, because they have two different valve bodies in it. So read that, type B valve body, which is what I have, and then just match up the gasket. It's got an extra hole and a slot in the spot, so it's got the right one. Got the clamp on there because that spring wants to open the separator plate up, and barring that bolt there, the rest of it's held together with the top half of the valve body. So I'll put that aside for now, and there's a bunch of springs in that that I have to change in this to give you the firmer shifts. So we'll do that.
Okay, finding more and more stuff wrong with this thing. Stage one of doing this, I've got a, there's supposed to be a little rubber puck in there that I'm supposed to remove and discard. It's not in there at all. And then there's a little modulator valve in here. I've got to pull this safety pin out and remove and discard the spring. So, okay. Could take a bit of doing. Well, that was a lot harder than I anticipated, but got it done. Now, stage two is to remove this copper plate. And there's some springs and shit in here I've got to change. There we go. Copper plate. And gasket. There we go, that come out. Right. There's supposed to be a fucking spring in there. And there isn't. The valves are stuck shut. Golly. What a mess. I don't know who's been inside this thing, but they haven't done a real good job of it. Come on now, that's not. Look at all that. Shit. Yeah, there should be a spring in here. Okay, discard original inner spring. Do not install spring here. Oh, I will not install a spring there. Now, it says gold. Huh, that one right there. Well, that took a lot longer than anticipated, but hey, we're here now. So, I'm going to lay these two together, nice and gently. Should be something like that, I think. Okay. Yep, that. That's all lined up there. Cool. take that off. Sweet. I'll button this up and that's that done.
One shift kitted, fully manualized, C10, valve body. Right, so that's about all I can do on the gearbox until these thrust washers come. So I guess we'll call that an episode. And I still got to tighten that bolt up. Good to know. So shut it down here. My pizza just turned up, so I want to rifle into that. Quick, smart, and in a hurry, I can tell you. So you guys, keep your upside down, and we'll catch you next time. I think there might be a bit of racing next time. We'll see.
What you doing? You filming one of them internet show things again? Okay. You told them that you don't do none of the work. Told me. You said you were going to tell them last time. Well, I did. I'll go back in. You tell them.